are a brother of a famous actor, but I don't use that tag anymore because yeah. you yourself is a person. Yourself is an actor, right?
Yeah. Yeah. What's your name means?
Sirish. Sirish actually means sensitive. I actually cursed my parents for giving me such a name. Mm-hmm. But now I learned to accept it because it's quite unique. Mm-hmm. Sirish is not a very familiar name. But I've made peace with it. I kind of like my name now.
Okay. How sensitive are you?
Pretty sensitive. But that time what they meant was not emotional sensitivity, physical. I used to be very fair as a kid. So even if they held me, I used to become pink. Or even if for 1 minute if they got me into the sun, I used to become red. Uh-huh. So for that's why they named me Sirish. Uh-huh. But I turned out to be emotionally, while like growing up, also slightly sensitive person.
Apart from what we heard, you are a fan of cricket. You are a big fan of cricket, I've heard so.
Cricket, yeah.
What was the feeling that went through when Sachin Tendulkar retired?
When Sachin, we were prepared for it from quite some time. I think he let us know that it is his coming to an end. So we kind of prepared for it. So it was not a shock, but I really felt emotional during his last speech. During his last speech,
the Wankhede Stadium.
Wankhede Stadium. I felt really like, shit, it's an end of an era. It's coming to the end of an era. But I luckily feel Indian cricket is in safe hands. And I think Virat Kohli has kind of taken over where Sachin left from. And I'm right now a big fan of Kohli.
Okay, when you were launched into movies, your biggest hindrance, maybe your biggest thing was, you had a big brother who was already a superstar in the movie.
Yeah.
You'll be always compared with that person.
True.
How did you manage to sneak away all those things and establish yourself?
So the first, what I chose to debut in is a message-based art house movie, mm-hmm. Gauravam. Mm-hmm. It was produced by Prakash Raj sir. And it was directed by Radhamohan, who's made many critically acclaimed message-based films. So the fact that I chose that itself, people have put me in a different slot that he's not going to be like his brother. I made those kind of films. And I'm not as good a dancer as him. He's a way superior dancer.
You were expecting that question, right?
Yeah. Naturally. And why not? If it is somebody's brother, if somebody's good at something, we'll naturally expect the sibling or the son to have similar stuff. I do dance, but not to his level. And let me put it this way, that my strengths are slightly different from his strengths.
Nice.
Yeah. So I choose different scripts. Not the regular out-and-out commercial ones. I go for slightly off-center scripts and all that. So that way we're kind of poles apart.
Okay. You came from a renowned production company. Everyone knows your name, your family's name, your father's name. Everyone knows that. Was that thing a difficult part or a good part?
Mm. About?
Being launched from a big production company.
I wasn't launched by my father. Mm-hmm. I was launched by Mr. Prakash. Mm-hmm.
No, I told that tag. I said,
but the tag comes with heavy expectations. So you always have to deliver to people's expectations or their idea of what you are supposed to be doing versus what you want to do. But let me be very clear and very upfront. It is a bonus. It is a luck. It is God's blessings to be born in a family where everything comes to you the way you want it. There might be expectations, there might be some criticism or whatever this, that if you don't deliver and all of that. But the upside is compared to the downside is so much. You know, because so many people I see are really struggling for an opportunity in films, despite having all the talent and looks and everything. But you know, so getting an opportunity itself is a huge thing. So you shouldn't complain that this, I don't want this, I can't take and all of that. So I treat it like a part of a whole package, and I consider myself blessed that I come from a family of actors and my dad is a big producer.
Okay. Then we'll talk about your new movie, Yodha.
What
do you have? Yeah, 97. What do you have to tell about the movie experience as such?
Experience, it's great. It's one of the best experiences in my life because we've all seen war films and we don't usually make such films in India to be a part of such films. So first thing that got me excited was a war film. And we didn't shoot it in studios. Yeah. We went to real army base camp location in Suratgarh, Rajasthan. So we've shot it there with real tankers. Some of the soldiers were real and real explosions. The explosions are not computer generated.
Oh, exactly.
Had real petrol bombs exploding on the set, the mud hitting us mm-hmm. and people flying mm-hmm. and all that. So it actually gave us a feel of the war. You know, it actually gave us a feel of the war. Okay. So it was one of my most memorable experiences in life.
We don't die, അത് നമ്മുടെ ശത്രുക്കളായിരിക്കും.
പാകിസ്ഥാൻ അവാം കോ ലഡായി ചാഹിയേ യാ നഹി ചാഹിയേ.
നമ്മ നാട്ടുകാർ ഉയർ കൊടുക്കുന്നത് നാ ഇപ്പം റെഡി.
വി സോൾജേഴ്സ് ജസ്റ്റ് ഫോളോ ദ ഓർഡേഴ്സ്.
What did you study from Mohanlal?
With Mohanlal sir, it is not one thing. Primarily, of course, working beside him, I did learn, absorb a few things about how he goes about his craft of acting and all that. He's very subtle. Without changing the content of the scene, he's able to add some small improvisations on his own, which add so much more depth and beauty. It'll get very technical if I explain what is it we've done, but then I really learned that you can add so much to a scene by doing some improvisations. That is as an actor. And his commitment to the craft, he was not well, he had a dust allergy. And we were shooting in Rajasthan. And it's dust every day. So after every shot, he used to put his, this thing, and he was having a, condition and all that. Yet he shot for 25 days there. One day he actually fell ill. One day we had to cancel shoot because he fell ill. Yet he didn't call off the schedule, he went, he shot, so that kind of commitment. And two, despite me being like a young upcoming actor, he never treated me like one. He treated me with so much love and respect, and he used to rehearse the scenes with me so that I get my lines, then give me small tips and tricks, what to do in the scene, help me, make me feel comfortable so that, it's a new industry, new language and all that. So these are the things which I really learned, and he's so humble and down to earth despite being the biggest star in Malayalam cinema.
Okay, that's nice to hear, man. Telugu movies are usually very much accepted here in Malayalam as well. What make you think that your movies are so acceptable here?
Primarily I think most successful have been my brother Allu Arjun's films.
It's called Mallu Arjun, right?
Mallu Arjun. So why I think his films have done well is because his dance, which is like not many of the local youngsters are such good dancers like him, and his style, the way he dresses, and on screen persona, his swagger, his fights, his over the heroic. His heroism is something which is fresh and new to the Malayalam audience, and I think also is fun, very fun, happy go lucky. Most of it have a nice love track.
But the other thing is that the same kind of movies, if it is made in Malayalam, people won't accept here in Malayalam. But they will accept the same type of movies when it comes from Telugu, right?
Same case in Telugu. Like if a Malayalam film is dubbed, we will watch it. Like we've seen Premam. Premam was remade, but we watched the original Bangalore Days. Best example. We all of us watched Bangalore Days.
Okay.
The Malayalam version. Mm-hmm. But the same thing when it was remade, people didn't take it.
Okay.
We've accepted, okay, this is Telugu cinema, okay, this is Tamil cinema, this is Hindi cinema. We've made segregations like that. But having said that, I think the borders are blurring. I think even Janta Garage did moderately well here. Pulimurugan. Pulimurugan was a big hit in Telugu also. They dubbed it. Called Manyam Puli. And it did very well for a dubbing film. They started accepting. There is a huge influence of Malayalam cinema on Telugu cinema today.
Okay.
Technicians, actresses, the realistic way of shooting films with minimal lights, real locations, without too much of art direction and, making it glossy. Because all of us filmmakers see those films and we fall in love with it. And we should also present our films like this. So that realism is coming back into Telugu cinema because of the Malayalam influence.
காதல் காட்டது என்னை உனக்குள்ளே நெஞ்செல்லாம் மழையே.